Okay, so now we've added a project, we've added tasks, and now the main thing, we got to add users. Unless you're going to be a one-man band and be the only user or the only project worker on your project, then you probably have multiple people and you're going to want to assign tasks to other people. So first, let's go to user roles. I would say some of the trickier areas of dotProject is user roles and user permissions. It's not overly complicated, but then again, it's not overly intuitive either. So here we got there going to system admin and then clicking on the user roles. And here are the default user roles that come stock with dotProject. So we have the admin, which is description administrator, has full rights, has rights to what's called admin modules and non-admin modules. To let you know the difference, a non-admin module would be the project task, calendar, companies, contacts, files, forms, tickets, and admin modules would be your user admin and your system admin. Pretty simple. We have anonymous. This is essentially no login at all. Guest, this would be very limited access, kind of read-only type access. And then we have project worker. Project worker would be no administrative rights, but full, let's call them admin rights for the, okay, that makes no sense, but for the non-admin modules, they have full write, edit, access capabilities, so administrative capabilities. And then you can create your own. You can name it whatever you want, give it a description, hit add. Once it's added, so I can give you a quick example here. Once it's added, you can then adjust the permissions. And to do that, you'll hit the lock icon. And this takes you to the permission screens where you can set up permissions for the role. I'm not going to do that here. Let's go take a look at one that's already built. And I'll show you how that's built. So let's take a look at how the admin role is built. All modules, all has access, add, delete, edit, view, allow. Okay, so what that means, we've selected admin modules, the items within the admin modules, all of them, we're allowing the ability to do all these things. And ACL administration, which is the user administration essentially. So the admin has all rights, all the things, all the time. Let's take a look at something a little more restrictive. Let's take a look at the project worker. I think this is the one that's most used. Probably admin and project worker are the most common. So let's take a look at that. Now, this has non-admin modules, has full access to non-admin modules. They can access, add, delete, edit, view, and we're allowing that. The user table, they have full access to that as well. So they can access and view it, but they can't delete users. They can't edit them, and so forth. So there is no rights to the admin module, so that's what you need to take a look at, is that the they would not be able to see the system admin or the user admin. So the user table in this case is that they can access or view the user table, meaning if there's a drop down that selects from users, then they'll be able to see that but not make changes to the actual user list. Okay, so let's take a look at let's edit test here and call it client spacely, and this is going to be spacely sprocket client. This one comes up a lot, so let's build some permissions for that. So when I want to give access to a client, this is the way I typically set one up, is I deny access to the admin modules. So I deny in whole absolutely anything. This is more precautionary on my regard, I guess. Now, so there's no access to the admin modules whatsoever. Okay, so now we're going to select which non-admin modules we want the client to have access to. What we want them to be able to view is projects, tasks, calendar, and that's it. Nothing more, nothing less, and only for their company. So this is where it gets a little funny. What we've got to do first is deny all non-admin modules. Alright? So at this point, the client has no rights. So now we're going to add company. We're going to leave it as all, and we're going to deny access to all. Access, view, add, edit, delete. So you may be asking me, well, now why am I doing all this denying? Well, the whole idea is to kind of wipe the slate clean, because if you don't, there's little odds and ends that pop up where a client can see other information that's not, should not be privy to them. So what I first like to do as a practice is deny access to everything and then build back what I want them to be able to see. So maybe a little far-fetched, but to me it's worth the time. So now I'm going to add, we've denied all companies, and I'm going to add them back to companies and give them access to the Space Loop sprockets. Give them allow access, view. They cannot add, they cannot edit, they cannot delete. Okay. So now they have access or the ability to, if they've given a direct link. But right now the module itself is off limit. So we gotta give those modules back to them. So we'll go to projects. Allow that access and view, and we have to add tasks, access, view, and I'm going to keep task logs at bay right now. This is a judgment call. Sometimes project workers get candid in logs, a little too candid for a client. So the best thing is to keep the client access to really only see progress. So that's what they'll be able to see. Let them contact your project manager for details. So right now what we've got is that we've denied access to everything, then we brought back that they can see only the company, Spacely Sprockets, and they can see projects, all projects that are Spacely Sprockets, all tasks that are assigned to Spacely Sprockets. And we forgot events, so we'll add that now. And just so you can see, when we were looking at tasks, I mean, you can literally let a user only see a single project. So, so now we're adding this and hitting add. So that's it. If I add a user and they have the client Spacely, their user rights are only going to give them project, tasks, and events. Did I not hit calendar? We want to show them the calendar, right? Yeah, I need to do that too. And add. Okay. So those are the modules they'll be able to see. Events is kind of a sub of calendar, really. But this way, they'll be able to. You've really kind of set a very limited scope on what a client is able to see. And because you don't want a client seeing other clients' information, so that's user roles. Let's hit and we'll go add a user now. We can go to user admin. So let's add a couple of users first. We'll give our client a login name of, I forgot the boss's name. And we'll give it to Jay. And we'll call her Jay Jetson. And her user type. Password. Jane Jetson. Spacely Sprockets. No department. Don't worry about the email. And I guess we have to give some kind of email. We'll call it jjetson@topsweb.com. And have them send an email, and we'll hit submit. Alright. So, Jane already has a role, we've already set up permissions. Now we can override those permissions. She already has a role, and right now we're giving her project, tasks, calendar, that sort of thing. For whatever reason, if you need to add additional information, let's say files, we can just add files from here. That's what's a little distressing to me about the way permissions is set up in dotProject, is that it should just already give you the roles layout because you already have it there and edit from off of that, but that's not the way it works. You have to already know what the roles are. So if you have any questions about the user roles that are in dotProject by default, you can, again, click the lock icon to see what those are, or you can go to http://docs.dotproject.net. That sounds a little bit confusing, so let me say docs.dotproject.net. Go there and search for creating user roles, and it will give you kind of a breakdown of how those are laid out. Okay. Again, we've created a role, and now we can edit off of that particular role, or add permissions, or take away permissions from that particular user's role. We can transfer projects from one user to another. If there were any selected here, if this person had quit, we can give all their projects over to another user. So you can look at the project Gantt and see what this user's got on tap. No projects have been assigned at this point. Here's a list of what projects they have. User kind of keeps a log of what's going on with that user. So we can also set preferences, and this may look familiar. Before, we set default preferences for all users, and now we have individual users can override those defaults and create their own. So let's say my base of people work in the United States, but I have Jane here from Australia. She can come in and change things and hit submit. And that takes us to the user list. When a user by default is added, they're not active. So you can change that in the system configuration where they're active automatically. But by default, you would have to come in here and click on Old Jane and activate her. So that's user management. Like I say, it's a little bit tricky. So for additional information, please go to docs.dotproject.net. Try saying that 10 times in a row fast. So thank you very much. That is user management.